اللهم انك اصبحنا وبك امسينا وبك نحيا وبك نموت واليك النشور. اللهم انا اصبحنا منك في نعمه وعافيه وستر، فاتم نعمتك علينا وعافيتك وسترك في الدنيا والاخره. اللهم ما اصبح بنا من نعمه او بحد من خلقك فمنك وحدك لا شريك لك، ولك الحمد ولك الشكر. Just again, we remind everyone, inshallah, that we have a WhatsApp group called MIA, Daily Khatira. So, alhamdulillah, in this group, we have everything that is posted in the masjid, any lectures that we live stream. So, alhamdulillah, we make sure that people are connected with the masjid, especially the brothers and the sisters who couldn't make it, inshallah. So please watch our halaqas, and if you have any comments, any things to ask, inshallah, just ask us on the private, because we make it for da'wah only, it's not for discussion. Just briefly today, we alhamdulillah, every Fajr, we like to talk about these little acts that in a short time, we inshallah give it to you as a gift, and then we practice it in our day, especially the adhkar. Alhamdulillah, we learn it a lot, alhamdulillah, from these adhkar, this treasure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us to the Muslim Ummah. Just before I want to mention this, subhanAllah, it came to my mind something that they taught us when we were young. That subhanAllah, the Quran has a miracle in the way that the words are pronounced. In Surah An-Nazi'at, when the Pharaoh collected the people and when he said, I'm your Lord the Most High, subhanAllah, there is, subhanAllah, a miracle in these words that he used. He said, فَحَشَرَ فَنَادَ فَقَالَ أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. سبحان الله. In the Quran, this is the only time you find nine fathas that came consequently. If they come in any language, you do not accept this. So سبحان الله. But in the Quran, when it came, سبحان الله, it comes in a beautiful way. فَحَشَرَ فَنَادَ فَقَالَ. You pronounce it with beauty. And if you remember before, when Nuh alayhi salam is addressed in the Quran, قِيلَ يَا نُوحُ اهْبِطْ بِسَلَامٍ مِنَّا وَبَرَكَاتٍ عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِمَّنْ مَعَكَ وَعَلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِمَّنْ مَعَكَ. How many memes? More than 9 memes in 3 words. And subhanAllah, they sound very nice and very perfect. SubhanAllah, this is the miracle of the Quran. We still, alhamdulillah, every day we learn something, alhamdulillah, that increase the beauty of the Quran when we listen to the ayat or when we ponder over the meaning. Let us talk about the prize of today, inshallah, dua or dhikr that everyone knows, but maybe we don't know about the reward of it. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam left our mother Juwayriya bint al-Harith. He left her when he went for Salatul Fajr, and she was saying a specific dhikr. And the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ got back at the duha time after he spent some time in the masjid. We will say a couple of hours, 2 hours or 3 hours. And then the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ came back, and Juwayriya was saying the same adhkar that she's saying. She was saying tasbih, tahmid, takbir, tahleel for 2 or 3 hours. The Prophet ﷺ said, I just said statement of dhikr for just to know less than 1 minute. If it is to be weighed with what you said from the time I left you till now, it will be the same or even heavier. Ya Allah. So in 3 hours, same dhikr, and the Prophet himself said one dhikr 3 times, that we can say it, I guess, in 1 minute or less. What is that? Subhanallah wa bihamdih. عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلمته. One more time. سبحان الله وبحمده. Glory be to Allah. And I praise Him. According to the number of the creations. عدد خلق. The number of the creation, we think that the number of people who live now. No. The number of the creatures means anything that Allah created. From a jinn, from the trees, from the heavens, the earth, everything in the universe from the time of Adam till the day of resurrection. Can anybody count this? So it says, Subhanallah, yubhamdi adada khalqi. Wa rida nafsi, according to his pleasure, or by his pleasure, the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something magnificent. The rahmah of Allah Azawajal is something magnificent. These are parts, and the barakah of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is something magnificent. These are some parts of the pleasure of Allah. Can we imagine the pleasure of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala? Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, adad khalqihi wa rida nafsihi wa zinat arshi. According to the weight of Allah, of the throne of Allah Azawajal, we say, oh, wa yahmilu arsha rabbika fawqahum yawma idhin thamaniyah. And the day of resurrection, only 8 angels, they carry the throne of Allah. This is the day of resurrection. And these angels, they are magnitude and they are magnificent and they have the superpower to carry this. But the number of the people who carry the throne of Allah Azawajal, we don't know. And we know the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the seven heavens and the earth, when you compare them to the kursi is the place where the feet is rested on that. So if they are compared to it, it is like a small earring or ring in a desert. This is the sevens and the earth compared to the seat, to Al Kursi. What about Subhanallah, the throne of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala? So we say Subhanallah wa bihamdi zinat arshi wa midad kalimati, and glory be to Allah in accordance to the ink for the words of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala that are used in the Quran and outside the Quran. Subhanallah wa bihamdi adad khalqihi wa rida nafsihi wa zinat arshihi wa midad kalimati. Inshallah, this is something we'll start our day with, inshallah. May Allah make our day full of barakah, Ya Rabbil Alameen. It will save a lot of time. We are saving 3 or 4 hours of dua by repeating this dua 3 times, inshallah. Subhanallah, wa bihamdi, adad khalqihi, wa rida nafsihi, wa zinat arshihi, wa midad kalimati. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our day with barakah, with love, with peace, with happiness, with adhkar, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullah khair. موريسا سكي جميل زكي.